Delegation works, but you have to connect. Delegation is great. It allows us to accomplish so much more by handing off tasks to others so that we can achieve more in our own day. However, sometimes we forget that it's more than just telling somebody what to do. What we're really doing is entrusting someone else with a task, our own task. When we entrust someone with something, we're doing something more than just throwing a project on their desk and demanding it to be returned to us with corrections by 5 o'clock. What we're saying is, I trust you. I trust that you have the understanding and the knowledge to get this done for me. Just as important as getting the project done is getting it done right. And that's where delegation may be difficult. You must be willing to relinquish control, relinquish philosophy and initial concept. In order for delegation to work, the people that are being delegated to need to have the same beliefs that you do, the same understanding of the situation, and the same goals in mind. Or it really doesn't work. I hear so much frustration expressed by managers as well as the individuals that work for them. The reason for their frustration? A lack of connection from manager to individual on details and directions. If I want you to carry out the tasks or ideas that I delegate to you, I have to first connect with you to make sure that you see it the way that I see it. What does this mean? Taking the time to look at the bigger picture. Why am I delegating this task to you? What do I want to achieve, both immediately and in the long run? How will this individual task impact the bigger picture? Sometimes we fall short because we forget why we are doing something, and when that happens, it makes room for errors, misunderstandings, and overall frustration. On the surface, delegating may seem to involve more speaking than listening, but actually that's not the case. It's your job as a delegator to make sure that the other individual understands what you're asking of them. You accomplish this by asking the right questions and listening to make sure that your requests were really understood. In taking 5 more minutes, you may have given them all the information they needed and actually be able to make sure that you're on the same page. Sometimes I forgo the 5 minutes and waste an extra 20 minutes on frustration and another 60 minutes time cleaning up what wasn't done right. And it was my fault, not theirs. Taking the extra time is a critical connection between what you want and what you're going to get.